In today's video, I'll be showing you how to make different types of textures. Yes, while we are making dresses or fashion illustration stuff, we need different types of textures sometimes. So here are some of the 8 textures which I have been practicing and I have been using. So just focus on how I'm doing it. And the first one will be herringbone texture. In this one, at the base, like on the starting of the base, we are using a dark color, or you can say you can use a light color sketch pen. And after completing the base of it, you just need to take a darker color pencil, of the same color, and start making horizontal lines. After making the horizontal lines, you need to make these slanting lines on one part of the one column, then the opposite of that, opposite of the slanting line in the another column. So basically, you need to make a V shape in the whole box. You need to make a V shape continuously with from where you are starting the pencil, like the line where you are starting, and the next line should be from where you are ending. So you need to be very careful at that time. And for the next one, I'll be making a plaid, and in this I'm using 3 to 4 colors, and here the same line you need to follow. Like first you need to make the base with the light color, then the next one is you need to take the darker color, a little bit of darker from the base, you need to take that, and you need to make horizontal and vertical lines as well. It should be a little bit broader, so you make sure that they are a little bit more, you know, broader type, as I am doing. Now you need to make the horizontal and vertical lines from the darker color, means darker color of the same shade or from the same family of the colors. You just make use of all the colors which will be attractive. I have used a green one, you can go for yellow, red and stuff. After making all those horizontal and vertical lines for the basic, you know, the middle part where the two lines are mixing, mix and matching the two lines where they are coming apart and making a small box, just take a darker color. It can be brown or red, depending on what color you have chosen, and fill all those boxes. Just you need to fill all the middle square boxes which are overlapping. The next one I will be making will be a shimmer one, and in this you just need to take one basic color and start making the color, or start filling the colors, you know, start filling the part which you want to be colored, and just leave a little, you know, just a little bit of white gap. Don't color that part and leave it like that. It will give you a shimmery effect or the silky effect which you want. The fourth one which we are doing will be a satin one, and as you know, it will be a little bit silky and smooth. So for this we'll be using a crayon, basic crayon. You can take off any color and start filling the shape or the space where you want it. And for this, for the smooth effect which we are going to give you, it's better to use your hands, mostly your fingers, because the smooth effect which we need will be available by using our nails. Because if we use a paper, it won't give that much of smoothness to the texture, and as we all know that satin is a lot more smoother, so it's better to use your nails or fingers. Just try, if you can try it up, like if you are okay with paper, you can use paper or hands as well. This part will be a little bit messy, but it will be a lot of fun. Our fifth texture will be a net, and for this it's really easy. This texture is very, very easy for you guys. You just need to make horizontal lines, vertical lines or slant lines from both the sides, and you will get your net texture. Or else you can use the scribbles or just a 0000 on your space or on the dress, you will get your net texture. This one is really easy. Our sixth texture will be fur, and for this you can use any color of your choice. I have used in purple, and in this you need to make just slanting or little curved lines as I am making, and it should not be in one direction. It should go in two directions or four directions. You just need to give that fur effect. As if we see a fur texture and if we feel it, it will be a, you know, meshy type. So for that look or for that texture, you need to be as free as possible and use curved lines. Our seventh texture will be of tweed texture, as we can say, and in this you need to make a base as usual, which we have made bases for our previous textures. I have used different shades of blue in this, and you can use any color of your choice. First you need to make a base, then you need to make horizontal and vertical lines. But this time you need to be very thin, like the space between them should be very thin, and start making horizontal and vertical lines as well. Then you can also go for slanting lines to give it a more meshy look. Go for both sides slanting, like horizontal in slant position and horizontal in vertical position. Then use different colors, like any two different colors, and just make a little bit of dots or a short lines so that it gives you a tweed texture. Our last texture will be the eighth texture, will be Gingham's texture, and for this also first we'll make a base, then make the horizontal and vertical line. This will be same similar as the plaits or pleats one, the space between the lines will be a little bit thinner and shorter. only the difference between the plaid and gingham texture will be we have made an extra horizontal and vertical lines in plaid, but in this we won't be making that, and the lines where the horizontal and vertical lines are interacting at on that part will again highlight the square boxes with any dark color. So yeah, this was all the texture, all the 8 types of texture which I have shown, and I hope you find it this helpful, and do try this out on your designs or on your dresses and tag me. Subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon as well, so you will be notified whenever I upload a video. And my Instagram page will the link will be present in the description box below, so do tag me in all your designs and I'll post it in my story as well. So till the next video, stay home and be creative.